Tonight's opening begins with a cult classic from Sucrum's Brewing. This is a dark lager with vibes of maltiness, darkness, and roasted flavor. And it's hopped with Barbe Rouge hops. Doesn't taste evil. First thing in is 4-pin socket, according to the customs lies. Oh, there's two things in here. We do have some 4-pin female headers, okay. And that is some kind of a USB thing. And we have a USB-A and a USB... Is that mini, micro? I can never remember. And looks like some power supply-ish components on the back. Oh, and we got the power connections there too. Okay. Oh, is that a power bank circuit? That could be what it is. Of course, there's no way to know exactly what that chip is because the bastards didn't put numbers on it. Fine, be like that. I'm going to say that that is a one cell, one lithium ion cell power bank circuit. 20 pieces, 4-pin, 2.54 millimeter female stackable header connector socket for Arduinmz. From MZVII1. Oh, great. It's got a relatively new seller. Got these for $2.50 for the 20 of them. Those aren't stackable. They're just standard female headers. The stackable ones have the extra long pins on them. Also from the same seller, 5-volt power bank charger circuit plate boost board lithium battery chargemz. I think that's what I'm going to call it. It's a battery chargemz. That was $2.40 as well with free shipping. Not a whole bunch of information down here. Charging current 1 amp, output current 1 amp, 5 volts. Yeah, of course, input 3.7 to 5.5. Okay. Yeah, it's just a simple little power bank. Convert any handy lithium-ion battery you got kicking around into a basic little power bank. Next in, one of the many that has been coming from the reshipping warehouse in Mississauga. That's okay. I don't mind that these Chinese sellers are using my tiny little bits of money to employ a few Canadian warehouse workers. Fine with me. Oh, this is parts for 3D printer. This is an upgraded extruder, what you call an all-metal extruder. So the stepper motor goes on there. Not this one, but it's the same size, so we'll just use it. That goes on there, and... this little shafty guy here, or geared guy, hang on. This little guy here goes onto the shaft. It meshes with that gear. So one turns the other one. And it grabs the filament in there from both sides and pushes it along. And the dual gear is an upgrade from the single gear that comes standard on the Ender 3 and a lot of other low-end printers. Also, this piece is not metal on the stock one. I don't think this piece is either. I don't know. Is this worthy of its own video? Anybody that interested in 3D printing upgrades? Let me know. Anyway, that's what that is. It is an upgrade. It's even got the pneumatic fittings for the Bowden tube, which you may remember I got some replacement of that a couple mailbags back. And that's a little lock so that those don't back off. These gears will grip onto the filament a little bit better so it won't slip. And by replacing these pieces that are currently plastic with metal, it should make the whole thing more reliable over the long term. Not that there's any problems with it right now, but from the reading that I've done, these are the places that it will wear out and need to be replaced eventually. Anyway, so I got parts on hand now so that when that happens, I can just replace it and not have to wait a month.
BIQU CR10 Pro Dual Gear Extruder Upgrade MK8 Extruder for Ender 3 5 CR10S. Got this from BIQU, which is Big Tree Tech. A manufacturer of an awful lot of aftermarket 3D printer parts. It is currently selling for $1,940 Canadian. I paid $1,850. The exchange rate has changed. And there's two different versions. One has a single pneumatic connector, and the one that I got has two. Only a couple of bucks difference in price. Free shipping. Woohoo! Anyway, there's kind of what it looks like assembled. There it really is. You can see the stepper motor down below there, meshing with those gears, and the filament path comes straight in from the top through the gears and out the bottom. And the reason you'd want the second pneumatic connector on there is just so that you can have some PTFE tubing running off to a dry box for your filament, just to keep the entire path out of humidity, or minimize it anyway. And of course, it's red, which means it goes faster, obviously.
Next in, we have something that comes from a supplier in BC, VJ Supplies, to be specific. See what these guys got for me. That is... Oh, okay. That's a USB cable. That goes onto a motherboard connector and just brings a couple of USB 3 ports out to the back plane of the computer. My editing computer, when I upgraded it a while ago, it doesn't have as many USB ports broken out onto the back panel as my previous one did. So right now I've got a couple of hubs on there, which aren't ideal. So this hopefully will give me a couple more ports, and specifically the higher speed USB 3 ports, so I can use them for, among other things, migrating footage, like what I'm doing right now, off my phone and onto my editing computer. Nice simple thing, nothing too fancy, just a very utilitarian little piece.
20-pin motherboard header, female to 2x USB 3.0 external back panel mount cable from 2006 GNS. Currently, they're selling for $7.99. When I got it, it was $7.54. Free shipping from Vancouver. It's not often I can find the best deal from a local supplier, but when I can, I absolutely like to support these guys. Nothing too exotic here. USB-A to motherboard header cable. Compliant with USB 3 spec. Two panel mount USB 3.0A ports with screws for secure installation. 19-inch cable length. So that's far more than I need, but that'll let me route the cables gently inside. Perfect.
Next in, again, from the Canadian warehouse, so no idea. Wire. Red and black wire. Oh, this is that super flexible silicone wire stuff. Okay. 18 AWG. Okay, that should be good for a fair bit of current. If I remember correctly, the reason that I bought this was so that I can make up some of my own cables for meters and stuff. You know, to replace these crappy Chinesium ones. And maybe even to make up a few a little bit better clip lead wires. Just with some heavier gauge wire so that I don't lose current when I'm doing measurements and stuff.
1 to 5 meter silicone wire, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22, 24, 26, AWG, red and black, optional. I bought 3 meters each of red and black of 18 gauge, and that cost me $3.83 for each color, which I think for this silicone wire is fairly typical. I went digging around and I couldn't find anything better on eBay back in, when did I buy this? Back in February. So here we are. This came from Ashley Trade 1984. Asterisk. I don't know what the asterisk means. Free shipping. Did I mention that already? According to this, -30 to +80 degrees Celsius. Good working range, so I can use them outdoors and automotive and whatnot. That's good. 300 volt insulation breakdown rating. Not going anywhere near that. Solid or stranded tinned or... Yeah, that's basically... It's wire.
PVC insulation. No. It's silicone, and it actually is. It is the super flexible silicone stuff. Don't believe anything you read anymore. But it is actually the silicone wire, which is what I was hoping for. So there we go. And rounding out the day's excitement, we have another one that comes through the Canadian warehouse. It's a kit. It's a kit with some big 7-segment LEDs in it. And a big chip. That is not a microcontroller that I recognize. ICL7107 CPLZ. Don't know what that guy is. Comes with a socket. That's good. Bunch of passive components. These little 7-segment dudes. Actually, fairly big ones. No, there is a transistor in there, but almost everything's being done by that big chip. From EQ kit, it has an input over there. There's DC 5 volts there. AMM-TE. I've ordered quite a bunch of kits. I can't remember which one this is exactly.
To the listings! ICL7107 Digital Ammeter DIY Kit Electronic Learning Kit New. From VST Store. Currently selling for $10.74 Canadian. Back when I bought it, it was $8.25. But of course, the listing has been updated by the seller, so nothing ever gets cheaper, does it? Operating voltage, 5 volts DC, 35 milliamps. I'm assuming that is just the load of the circuit. It is accurate, plus or minus 1 milliamp. We will try that out when we build it. Its measurement range is 0 to 2 amps. Okay. Display color red. Yeah. Manual, please contact us. That's annoying. I'll have to see if I can find it before I build this thing up. Although, as long as the components are marked properly on the board, which they seem to be, I shouldn't need the manual. It doesn't say anything else about it. Huh. But with a little bit of Googling around, I managed to find a manual. So yeah, that one chip looks like it does everything, including reference voltage source and display drivers and all the rest. Oh wow, it's even got an order of operations for assembly. That's nice. Although the translation is a little bit suspect in this manual. I may have to reread it a couple of times just to figure out what it means. Talking about between 36 feet and 35 feet, the voltage is 100 millivolts. But at least I've got a manual, which is nice.
And there is the contents of today's Mailbag Monday haul. Quite the variety again. And I seem to have gone through it fairly quickly. I didn't get a chance to go too far into my beer. Anyway, shipping times. The USB cable took 9 days because that just came from a Canadian seller in BC. The header pins and the battery chargemz, I love that name, took 20 days to get here. The ammeter kit took 66 days. No wonder I forgot about it. The silicone wire took 17 days. And this dual gear extruder, which should be an interesting upgrade for my printer, took 39 days. Well, yeah, thanks for watching, everybody. Thanks to my Patreon supporters for helping pay for this madness and buying me a beer. I appreciate that, guys. Everybody else, yeah, questions, comments down below. Thanks for watching. I'll talk to you later.